Hello, Riders and Rangers. Welcome to How to Fix Operation Overdrive Part 3, Heroes. The previous two parts are about the pilot arc and villains. If you haven't watched those yet, I'd recommend you to do so first. Ready? Overdrive, accelerate.
The idea behind Operation Overdrive is a security team of the Division of Department of Energy Residue, DER for short. They are an energy scavenger safety group. Whenever the Rangers from previous season morphs, use their Zords, and use energy attacks, they leave residue morph and grid energies. These energies have to be safely removed, like radiation, otherwise the results could be disastrous. The residue could cause unexpected explosions or mutate beings into monsters, called chiral lights. I basically used the term chiral because chiral means similar yet opposite in chemistry. Like your left hand looks like your right hand, but they are opposites. In this case, the villains have powers based off of the good guys from previous seasons. For example, Mulder is the villain but it looks like the first Megazord from Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. Heroes. For our Rangers this season, there were a number of candidates scouted, since not everyone could withstand the residue energy. Spencer tested the suit and it put him in the hospital for a week. Mr. Hartford tried and it badly damaged his nerve endings on his legs, he can never run again. The maximum number of Rangers are only 5 because they do not have enough power to morph an army. No DNA splicing or enhancing happened. There are no civilian powers. Mentor Mr. Hartford. Let's talk about the season's mentor, Mr. Andrew Hartford. And you know what, I'm letting him keep his real accent. So Mr. Hartford is in charge of the security team called Operation Overdrive. He is very intelligent to the point he comes off as condescending to his team despite he cares a lot for them. He maybe can be overbearing at times, focusing on the destination rather than the journey. Mr. Hartford is too smart for his own good. His reason for becoming the mentor of the season is through guilt. When he was young, Mr. Hartford was an eccentric billionaire who earned his wealth from being the Indiana Jones of the Power Rangers universe. The DER tried to recruit him but Mr. Hartford arrogantly turned them down. When he started collecting pieces of Megazords and didn't listen to the DER's hazard warning, the treasures he collected made him lose his family. He regrets spending so much time and effort on personal gain rather than helping the world. Ironically enough, Mr. Hartford's train of thought is science-based although he often wishes he has supernatural abilities to just conjure up things. Mr. Hartford leads the team at times through the computer to fight monsters and he teaches his Rangers about past seasons. Often, he tries to act young and hip, and wants to redo his past. He wishes he had joined the DER much earlier than before. Despite being middle-aged, Mr. Hartford tries to act 20 years younger and the other Rangers tease him for acting like a man-child. He is a fan of the veteran Power Rangers. Mr. Hartford has a playroom filled with magic tricks, fictional collectibles from a fictional witchcraft video game, comic books about adventures of sorcerer superheroes. He is also obsessed with a secret artifact that he has found. Whenever he is off-screen and the Rangers are looking for him, the running gag that Spencer tells the other Rangers Mr. Hartford is trying to be the superhero swordman. Due to Mr. Hartford's extensive knowledge of planning and archaeological digs, he could easily predict and prospect chiral energies before they become dangerous. Mr. Hartford desires he can fight alongside the Rangers but his body cannot. Sometimes, Mr. Hartford just wishes the power of belief would allow him to be one. Mr. Hartford's catchphrase after saying things that's way too hard for Rangers to understand, Spencer, translate what I said to English. Spencer is the season's comic relief. He is the sassy British butler and a master of disguise. Mr. Hartford will be the logical side of mentoring and Spencer is often there for emotional support for the Rangers. Each villain's relation to Mr. Hartford. Each of these villains are like the antithesis of our heroes. Each of the villains are an embodiment of a crutch of Mr. Hartford as well. Crutches that Mr. Hartford has overcome or is learning to overcome. Mulder is the embodiment of Mr. Hartford's past haunting him. Flurious represents how DER and Overdrive could be corrupted into, raising an army because of the chilling feeling of paranoia. Due to neglect, Mr. Hartford lost the piece of the White Mystic Ranger's wand which ended up turning Flurious into what she is now. Camder reflects that Mr. Hartford's greed of fame and fortune destroyed his family. In addition, Mr. Hartford called off the search of Naseda when they were trying to retrieve the Ninja Megazord and Shogun Megazord. The Fear Cat's behavior represents Mr. Hartford's psychopathy, where he is so obsessed with the end goal at times, he may be seen as apathetic and uncaring. Alpha, T-Skin. The Alpha of the season is called Skin. He is represented by an anthropomorphic Overdrive logo with silver and maroon colors. He has a cute childish voice, his target audience is children, basically imagine Ewoks and Porgs. As a meta joke, the merch of this mascot would sell big, carried by children everywhere. Skin serves as the avatar that relate all of their missions and gives them detailed plans from the overseer of DER. Overdrive Ranger Red Mac. Now onto the Overdrive Rangers, let's start off with Mr. Hartford's son, Mac, the Red Ranger. He is the leader of the team, highly trained and well educated, he is too overqualified for street sweeping. He knows all theoretical things on how to be an explorer, both book smart and street smarts. His main forms of entertainment are pole arm training and cheesy adventure novels. Time and time again, despite being a competent big brother and leader of the Overdrive team, you can secretly see Mac resent to be roped into his father's ideals. He dreams of being an adventurer rather than an over-glorified garbage collector. Mac personally believes dear old dad resents that Mac is in the Red Ranger role. Mac thinks his father is projecting what he wants to be onto Mac. Mac was a treasure hunter temporarily, but was pulled out of it after a traumatic adventure experience, forced to follow up family business. Mr. Hartford is very overprotective of his son due to the near-death experience. Mr. Hartford and Mac later learn to sort out their differences. Mac started off being a selfish, egotistical, demanding teacher. Throughout the season, he learns to let it go and sees other Rangers' points of views are as important as his. He could sacrifice himself for his team. Overdrive Ranger Pink Rose. The Pink Ranger looks like a flower but stings like a bee is Rose. She is quite reserved and isn't too emotive over her emotions, she puts a smile on her face but only as a front. Quite aloof and builds walls, she puts a strong exterior but is very soft internally. Rose is a caretaker for Mac. Officially, she is his secretary, unofficially, she is more of a babysitter for Mac, they have known each other for a long period of time. However, Mac sees her more of a mole planted by his side so his father could monitor his movements. Expert in weapons, Rose has a lot of input for each overdrive sidearm. She was originally an Olympic candidate for shooting but went to pursue her studies as a professor in engineering while also working in the military. Similar to Rose who creates weapons for defense because she herself is internally weak, both Rose and Flurious put walls around themselves which may make her seem off-putting and cold. Rose joined the army before so she won't be harmed again while Flurious is using magic to raise an army so she would never be harmed again. Overdrive Ranger Yellow Ronnie. The Yellow Ranger is Ronnie. Free-spirited and fun young sister of the group, she receives each mission with excitement and enthusiasm. Ronnie is hired because she is a gearhead and enjoys robotics a lot. With her expertise in robotics, sometimes she is there to help out Mac's condition. Mr. Hartford says Mac was in a glacier cave accident which caused majority of his limbs to be amputated and be replaced by robotic parts. Being a rule follower, Ronnie sees robots as orderly and logical. In Ronnie's senior year, there was a robotics competition which she was in charge of. She tried to experiment with mechanics in her robot. Her final product was experimental and didn't follow any blueprints. Due to the lack of proper instructions and panic during the tournament, Ronnie's team lost the competition and was a huge embarrassment for her school, the first loss in decades of victory streaks. She lost her scholarship and dropped out of her university placement due to shame. This may have led to her atachyphobia, the fear of failure. Thrill of speed riding, stunt driving, and gear mechanics building are her ideas to numb herself from the worst moment of her life. That worst memory is also why she is so vehement in following the rules and enjoys the thrill of speed, metaphorically running away from her past. Ronnie fears the failure so much, she is so competitive to the point that after having 8 consecutive winnings on Grand Prix racing, she quit raceway driving. Ronnie fears losing a lot, she rarely plays games with other Rangers, and when she plays it, she only plays it for the win. Even though the race car Zord was tailored for Ronnie, she swapped it for a Dozer instead. Later, she learns to focus more on the present, the journey is important than the destination and can never run away from the past but to accept it. Overdrive Ranger Blue Dax. For our Blue Ranger of the season, Dax is hired based on being the scout and information of the group. With his training in ninja sensory perception, Dax is an expert in geography and geology. In his previous job, he scouts out film locations that's safe and proper for the crew but never receives any appreciation due to being an oddball. Dax is seen as raining on people's parades because he can predict the environment easily. Even though nobody takes Dax seriously, he jokes around but he is serious when he needs to be. Being 5 steps ahead of everyone, Dax capitalizes on the fact he plays an idiot to fool everyone, including his teammates, but has a big plan at the end. That's why Mr. Hartford chose him to be the information expert. Mr. Hartford sees through his goofy exterior. Dax is a diamond in the rough. He is also chosen as the designated pilot. He is open-minded, happy-go-lucky, and believes the good in everyone. Graduated from the Ninja Academy, he is only good at the spiritual side of the ninja and is not good at performing the ninja arts. Mari Trix, Dax's rival, wants to use ninja powers for self-gratification, while Dax wants to use ninja to help the world. His world was turned upside down when he realized there are evil ninjas after being kidnapped by Lothar. With Lothar's defeat, does not want to fight another ninja clan as he sees good in all ninjas. Dax wants to feel appreciated and that's why he chose to be a ranger, front and center in the lead. But he learns that operating from the background is as important, Overdrive taught him that. Overdrive Ranger Black Will. In one of the shady characters, Will is our season's Black Ranger. An expert in picking locks, both digitally and physically, he is an electronic IT expert in computer hacking and break-ins. Banks, museums, and important storage of information and valuables hire him to test security measures. Secretly, Will actually spy on these companies and leak out information to the highest bidder. Often seen as the smug, too cool for school kind of character, he disobeys orders from time to time, which clashes with Ronnie and Mr. Hartford. He doesn't take anything seriously and sees Power Rangers does more destruction than good. He finds Max fanboying over previous Rangers pathetic. The biggest reason Will is on the Overdrive team is for ambitious personal gain. He wants to download enough information about Operation Overdrive and DER so he can start his own company, reverse engineering what the DER has created. Although he has a rivalry with one of the season's boss villains, Camder, he often is seen in the upper hand, strange enough. Also, whenever the team figured out the next location or item to pick up, Camder's forces would show up first unless they got pushed aside by the other villains with bigger armies. Throughout the season, Will went from money hungry to someone who cares about humanity. He learns how to operate as a team and trust his teammates in the future. He later shadowed the newcomer, finally learning how to be a big brother of the family rather than the rebellious young brother. Mercury Ranger Dizon. Throughout the season, after many encounters with Dizon, Mac was able to convince Dizon to join the good side. Mac promised with Overdrive's technology because he wants to save people rather than causing so much destruction under Molter's orders. Mac believes they can figure something out to reverse Dizon's mutation. Although Dizon joined the Overdrive team, he remained in his monstrous reptilian form until much later. Mr. Hartford was able to recalibrate Dizon's morpher so it could allow Dizon to choose to morph into the Mercury Ranger and nullify the constant pain he has been suffering. But the trade-off to removing pain is that it nerfed his strength. Dizon's own body contains a lot of chiral energies which could be used to power up his own Mercury Ranger suit, unlike the other Ranger suit which is powered by the Overdrive's own artificial morphin grid. Throughout the season, Molter tempts Dizon to return to his side, which creates tension and divides the team from time to time. Every time the team stops arguing, their bonds grow stronger. Dizon's character arc is to recover from his obsession, depression, survivor's guilt, and differentiating justice and revenge. Overall for the Rangers, they start off seeing each other as colleagues at first, and don't become friends and comrades until later throughout the season. Mac and Dax bonded over adventure novels and movies. Will and Ronnie bonded over machines and tech. Rose and Dizon bond over their related backgrounds, since Rose used to be in the military and Dizon was used to be in a search and rescue team. Overdrive suits, powers, arsenal, equipment, and Zords cannot be mass-produced because the chiral morphin grid energy saved so far could only power up 5 suits. Tizon's own body contains a lot of chiral energies which could be used to power up his own Mercury Ranger suit. As a recap, the Overdrive team's morphers are based off of Lost Galaxy's Transmorpher. The powers are basically recycled residue morphin grid energies. The suits give the Rangers intuition on how to fight and drive the Zords. There was a debate between Rose and Mr. Hartford about this matter, brainwashing vs intuition. Downloading data into Ranger memory so they could fight better is questionable. Technology such as this could land in the wrong hands. At the end, Mr. Hartford agreed with Rose. He destroyed the technology where it allows information to be downloaded into their brain. The other Rangers agreed to this, but they will now work extra hard and train more to make up for such a huge handicap. However, Mac doesn't seem to be affected by this much, his abilities and intuition remain the same. Somehow, the morpher can be used to leave clues behind, messaging, act as a walkie-talkie, small computer device, hook gun, chiral energy scanner and camera. The morphers and weapons have to be voice activated for security measures. There was once a fear cat that tried to use the Ranger's drive defenders and it was not activated due to voice recognition safety. Mr. Hartford has a teleporter but it could only teleport non-living items, so he could only teleport Zords and weapons. The Overdrive suits and Zords are modeled after Power Rangers Turbo, Space Rangers, and Lightspeed Rescue Zords. This is why the season is vehicle themed. Some of the Zords are reverse engineered from Turbo Zords and Space Zords remnants. These Zords are created not for fighting but intended for a cleanup crew. A few examples for reverse engineering old Zords would be the Sonic Streaker, when the Mega Winger was completely trashed and Mr. Hartford could only salvage its wings as blueprints. With some reverse engineering from Time Jet, he used parts of the Mega Winger to produce this.
Thank you for watching How to Fix Operation Overdrive Part 3. In our next part, it will be stories about the veteran Rangers returning. How do you have written the heroes? What did you think about the heroes? Who is your favorite? Please comment below, give this video a thumbs up, and subscribe.